So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. In this session guys, we are going to do some more important questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams, especially for the RBI Grade B and NABARD Grade A exam. And for the last 1 week there were no sessions because it was announced on YouTube community that the entire team was on vacation, but now we all are back with great zeal and great enthusiasm. So everything will be covered, and yes, please do remember, I will cover all the backlog. Jitna bhi piche chhoot gaya hai hamara, everything will be covered, so you guys don't have to worry anything. And in today's session, we are going to cover PIB news from 27th to 28th June. Right, 27th or 28th June ka aaj hum cover karenge, but don't you worry guys, jitna bhi backlog hai, everything will be covered. You will not lose a single important news from PIB, alright. So just have faith on me, or bus you guys just have to watch these videos and revise from the PDF, nothing more than that, alright. So let's begin with the session, but if you want to have your all-round preparation of all the government exams, you can download the Anujan Dal app from the Google Play Store. And if you want to have the PDF of this session, you can join the Telegram channel, the link is provided in the description, alright. So let's talk about the very first question, and from now on, 3-4 sessions will be, lengthy, ठीक है, जो सेशन होंगे थोड़े से लंबे होंगे, बिकॉज ऑफकोर्स हमें बैकलॉग अगर खत्म करना है तो हमें सेशंस को लंबा करना पड़ेगा. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, एंड इट इज द वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. आई बिलीव दैट दिस विल कम इन योर एग्जाम, एनी एग्जामिनेशन दिस क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दिस न्यूज विल डेफिनेटली कम. ऑलराइट, सो कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू परफॉर्मेंस ग्रेडिंग इंडेक्स डिस्ट्रिक्ट. नाउ दिस टाइम the Ministry of Education has released the performance grading index for district level, all right, and you have to identify the correct statement. Okay, so let's talk about this performance grading index guys. So remember, the Department of School Education and Literacy, which of course works under the Ministry of Education, has released the performance grading index district level ke liye, all right, and this has been released for the years 2018-19 and 2019-20, right. For the year 2018-19, 725 districts were covered, ठीक है, but उस एक साल में there were 8 more districts added to the various states, and therefore in the year 2019-20, 733 districts were covered in this index. All right. Now, what is the objective of this index? So, as the name suggests, it is a performance grading index school level education के लिए. All right. So it assesses the performance of school education system at the district level. That is the objective behind compiling this index. All right. Now talking about this index, guys, so remember it consists total points. Total points kitne hai isme, how many total points are there? Which means the districts are awarded points out of 600. There are total 83 indicators, and these 83 indicators are divided into 6 categories, or you can say are grouped into 6 categories. And which are these 6 categories? These are these: outcomes, effective classroom transaction, infrastructure facilities and students entitlements, school safety and child protection, digital learning and governance process. So these are the 6 categories in which these 83 indicators are grouped. Now you guys don't have to remember the name of these 6 categories, just remember that there are 6 categories with 83 indicators. And further, these 6 categories are divided into 12 domains. Alright, please don't get confused, 83 indicators, 6 categories and 12 domains. And which are these 12 domains by the way? These are these. Okay, now again you don't have to remember the name of these domains. This is just for your basic understanding that what are these domains actually. Right, so ye 12 domains hai, bas inka ek bar padh lo, there is no need to remember these domains. Alright, moving ahead. Now grading, the index grades the districts into 10 grades. Now you don't have to remember the 10 grades. ठीक है, जितने भी 10 के 10 grades हैं, one second guys, yeah, जितने भी 10 के 10 grades हैं, you don't have to remember. Just remember the highest grade is called as Daksh, which is given to that district which scores more than 90% of the total points, right? And talking about lowest grade, so it is Akanshi 3, which is given to that district which has scored up to 10% of the total points. Alright. So Daksh lekin kisi ko bhi nahi mila hai. Not even a single district has been graded this this grading of Daksh. Alright, kisi ko bhi nahi mila hai. Now moving ahead. Now let's talk about the key highlights from the index. क्या क्या key highlights है? So number one is none of the districts attained the highest grade daksh in both the years 2018-19 and 2019-20, which means there is a huge scope of improvement in the among all the districts, right? Number two, three districts of Rajasthan, which are Sikar, Jhunjhunu and Jaipur. Do remember the name of the districts? Very, very important. Sikar, Jhunjhunu and Jaipur reached Utkarsh. ठीक है, Utkarsh grading इनको मिली है. Now, the districts which scored more than 80% are awarded Utkarsh, right? So, more than 80% score जिनका होता है, these are awarded as Utkarsh grade, okay? So, these three districts of Sikar, Jhunjhunu and Jaipur of Rajasthan reached Utkarsh, which is more than 80% score grade in the year 2019-20. However, in the year 2018-19, not even a single district reached this grade, ठीक है? और दक्ष तो ऑफ कोर्स किसी को भी नहीं मिला, neither in 2018-19 nor in 2019-20. Alright, number of districts in Ati Uttam, which is awarded to those districts which have scored 71 to 80%, right, has increased from 49 to 86 during 2018-19 to 2019-20. Alright, number of districts in this category, which is Ati Uttam, and Ati Uttam is the category of states which have scored 71 to 80% in this index. All right, and this number has been increased from 49 to 86. Okay, talking more about this, so Rajasthan has the highest 24 districts in Ati Uttam grade, followed by Punjab, which has 14. Then we have Kerala, which has 13, and then we have Gujarat, which is again has 30. All right, so do remember the sequence. And if anyone asks you that which state has topped the index, okay, वैसे दिस क्वेश्चन विल नॉट कम बिकॉज दिस इज अ डिस्ट्रिक्ट वाइज इंडेक्स, बट एनीवेज इफ समवन आस्क यू दैट विच स्टेट हैज टॉप्ड दिस इंडेक्स, द आंसर वुड बी राजस्थान. द आंसर वुड बी व्हाट? राजस्थान, फॉलोड बाय पंजाब, गुजरात एंड केरला. ऑलराइट, प्लीज डू रिमेंबर दिस. नाउ देयर आर 12 स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज व्हिच डू नॉट हैव अ सिंगल डिस्ट्रिक्ट इन द अति उत्तम ग्रेड कैटेगरी, राइट? एंड व्हिच आर दीस 12 स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज? दीस आर दीस. No need to remember, just remember that there are 12 states and UTs which do not have a single districts in the Ati Uttam category of this performance grading index. Alright. And finally, overall 8 districts have improved their PGI score by more than 20%, and there are 14 districts which have improved their PGI score by more than 10%. Alright, do remember this. There are 8 districts which have improved their score by 20%. And there are 14 districts which have improved their score by more than 10%. All right. So that's it about this index, guys. और इससे ज़्यादा detail में तुम्हें कोई नहीं पढ़ाएगा और तुम्हें पढ़ने की ज़रूरत भी नहीं है. All right. So now let's talk about the correct statement. All right. The index consists of 83 indicators grouped into 6 categories, which are further divided into 12 domains. This is absolutely correct. And now, please don't get confused. मैं फिर से बोल रहा हूँ, there are 83 indicators grouped into 6 categories, and these 6 categories are divided into 12 domains. Okay, so this is absolutely correct. Three districts of Rajasthan, which is Sikar, Jhunjhunu and Jaipur, reached Utkarsh grade in 2019-20. बिल्कुल सही बात है. And not even a single district reached this grade in their 2018-19. All right, there was only one district, that is Kurukshetra, that reached Utkarsh grade in 2018-19. Is that so? No, this is incorrect. And finally, overall 8 districts improved their PGI score by more than 20%, and 14 districts improved their PGI score by more than 10%. So this is absolutely correct. There is no problem with this, which means we have this one is correct, this one is correct, and this one is correct. Therefore, the correct answer, guys, will be option D. Only 1, 2, and 4 will be the correct answer. Alright, I hope this question is clear, and please do remember this is a very, very important index. You will definitely get one or two questions in your examination. Moving ahead to question number 2. Consider the following statements with respect to Nasha Mukt Bharat Abhiyan, or you can say Addiction Free India Campaign. In English, it is Addiction Free India Campaign. And you have to identify the correct statement. Alright, so let's talk about this. Remember, this has been organized. This is a campaign which is Nasha Mukt Bharat Abhiyan. It was organized by Department of Social Justice and Empowerment, which is of course under Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. All right. Now this campaign was organized to aware our youths about the drug abuse and how they can stay away from the drug use. All right. And it was organized, remember, in association with a trust which is known as Health Fitness Trust, which is located in New Delhi. And there was a theme also. ठीक है, देयर वाज अ थीम आल्सो व्हिच इज शेयर फैक्ट्स ऑन ड्रग्स सेव लाइव्स. डू रिमेंबर द थीम, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. शेयर फैक्ट्स ऑन ड्रग्स सेव लाइव्स वाज द थीम ऑफ दिस कैंपेन एंड इट वाज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड इन 272 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स ऑफ द कंट्री एंड द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ सोशल जस्टिस एंड एम्पावरमेंट हैज सेट अ टारगेट दैट it will identify 100 districts and make those districts as drug free by the end of 2022, which means in short 100 districts will become drug free by the year 2022, by the end of 2022. All right, so that's it. Is news mein hame itna hi padhna hai. And can you tell me who is the minister of social justice and empowerment? Please write down in the comments. I have told you so many times. Agar jo log naye hain jinko nahi pata hai to no problem, main aapko aage chalke bata dunga. All right, please don't mind this. Now you have to identify the correct statement. It was organized by Department of Social Justice and Empowerment. This is absolutely correct. No problem with this. It was organized in 272 districts of the country. This is also correct. It was organized in association with Health Fitness Trust in New Delhi. Bilkul sahi baat hai. So all 1, 2 and 3 should be the correct answer because we have to identify the correct statement. And during the examination, please focus on this word. Whether you have to identify the correct statement or the incorrect statement. All right. Moving ahead, guys, to question number 3. All right, consider the following statements with respect to textile sector of India, and you have to identify the incorrect statement now. Please focus on this word, whether you have to identify the correct or incorrect. Now the question is, why we are discussing about the textile sector of India? Is it in news? Yes, it is in news because there was an event which was organized in which the Minister of Textile, which is Mr. Piyush Goyal, he participated. Now that event was organized to celebrate the success of textile hubs of Tiruppur. Theek hai, there is a textile hub in Tiruppur jo ki bahut hi successfully kaam kar raha hai, which is working very successfully, and to discuss and to celebrate its success, this event was organized. And during that event, the Minister of Textile, who is Mr. Piyush Goyal, has announced that Government of India will going to set up 75 such textile hubs across the country on the lines of textile hub which was set up in Tiruppur. All right, getting my point? Ki ye kya hua hai yahan pe? Jo hamare Union Minister of Textile hai Piyush Goyal, he participated in an event, and that event was organized to celebrate the success of a textile hub which was set up at Tiruppur. And during that event, the minister has announced that Government of India will set up 75 such textile hubs across the country. Alright, that's it. Now, इसी के दौरान, during this event, he talked about the textile sector of India, and that's why we are discussing it. Alright, so what is the important fact from the minister's statement? So number one, textile is the second largest provider of work across the country after the agriculture sector. ठीक है, agriculture के बाद सबसे ज़्यादा काम provide कराने वाला sector कौन सा है? Textile sector है. Alright. And the industry size is about 10 lakh crore, and out of this, the export size is around 3.5 lakh crores. Okay, 3.5 lakh crores. All right. The textile sector has the potential to grow to 20 lakh crore in the upcoming 5 years with export of rupees 10 lakh crore. Iske paas potential hai that it will grow up to 20 lakh crores in the upcoming 5 years. All right. And a modest export target of 7.5 to 8 lakh crore and production target of about 20 lakh crore in the next 5 years has been set. And roughly there are 3.5 to 4 crore people who are engaged in the textile sector in the country. Alright, so these are some of the important facts which were told by the Minister of Textile Piyush Goyal during this event. Okay. And Mr. Piyush Goyal is also the Minister of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, and he is also the leader in Rajya Sabha. Alright, so now let's come back to the question then. Textile is the largest work provider in India. Is that so? No, it is the second largest after agriculture. Alright, so this is incorrect. The industry size is about 10 lakh crore, bilkul sahi hai. The export is about 3.5 lakh crore, ye bhi sahi hai. And only roughly 3.5 to 4 crore people are engaged in total value chain of textile sector. So this is also correct, which means only 2, 3 and 4 will be the correct answer. Or PIB ke इन सेशंस को ध्यान से देखना, ठीक है, क्योंकि एग्जैक्ट स्टेटमेंट उठ के आते हैं पीआईबी में से आपके एग्जामिनेशन में. सो प्लीज कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन दीज सेशंस. ऑलराइट, इनको ऐसे ही मत ले लेना. ऑलराइट, क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 पे चलते हैं अब. रिसेंटली मिनिस्टर ऑफ डिफेंस हु इज मिस्टर राजनाथ सिंह एंड हिज लोकसभा कंस्टिट्यूएंसी इज लखनऊ. which is of course in Uttar Pradesh, has interacted with its counterpart of a country. ठीक है, both sides discuss the existing defence cooperation activities and framework between the two countries and ways to further enhance them under the existing MIDCOM framework. So you have to identify the country. All right, with which country this meeting was held? ठीक है, with which country's defence minister? Our defence minister held this meeting. ठीक है, कौन से देश के मिनिस्टर ऑफ डिफेंस के साथ हमारे मिनिस्टर ऑफ डिफेंस की मीटिंग हुई थी? ऑलराइट, सो दिस वाज मलेशिया. रिमेंबर दिस, मिनिस्टर ऑफ डिफेंस राजनाथ सिंह हैज इंटरैक्टेड विद हिज मलेशियन काउंटर पार्ट एंड देयर वाज अ डिस्कशन अबाउट इंडिया मलेशिया डिफेंस कोऑपरेशन. ठीक है, नाउ क्या क्या हाईलाइट्स हैं उस मीटिंग की वो हम पढ़ लेते हैं. नंबर वन, बोथ कंट्रीज हाईलाइटेड द एरियाज इन विच इंडियन डिफेंस इंडस्ट्री कैन सपोर्ट द मलेशियन डिफेंस इंडस्ट्री. ऑलराइट, इन विच Indian defense industries could assist Malaysia. Number one, the major point was this. Number two was, Malaysia expressed the need for inducting women personnel. This is very, very important. Women personnel in peacekeeping missions and both sides agreed on this. ठीक है, Malaysia ने बोला है कि भाई महिलाओं का participation होना चाहिए in the peacekeeping missions and both the countries have agreed to this point. All right. Both countries agreed to upgrade the humanitarian assistance and disaster relief operations. HADR operations को upgrade करने की बात करी है दोनों ही countries ने. And both sides discussed the existing defense cooperation activities or the framework. And that framework is known as what? MIDCOM framework, which is Malaysia-India Defense Cooperation Meeting Framework. ठीक है? So that is why the country in question is Malaysia. And finally, remember this MIDCOM. ठीक है, ये MIDCOM का जो नेक्स्ट मीटिंग है, इट विल हेल्ड इन द मंथ ऑफ जुलाई 2022, विच मींस दिस मंथ दिस ईयर. ऑलराइट, सो दैट इज इट. इससे ज्यादा डिटेल में जाने की जरूरत नहीं. एंड दीज एवरीथिंग आई हैव टेकन फ्रॉम द PIB. ऑलराइट, कुछ भी नहीं छोड़ा है. सो नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द कंट्री. द कंट्री इन क्वेश्चन इज मलेशिया. ऑप्शन सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. आई होप यू गाइज हैव अंडरस्टूड दिस क्वेश्चन. Moving ahead to question number 5. Consider the following statements with respect to UN Ocean Conference and you have to identify the correct statement. Again, a very, very important question. I believe this will also come in an exam. This United Nations Ocean Conference was attended by Dr. Jitendra Singh, who is the Minister of Earth Sciences and the Minister of Science and Technology from India's side. He led the Indian delegation. All right. So let's talk about this. The United Nations Ocean Conference took off, ठीक है, and the leaders from more than 130 countries participated. It was held in Lisbon, which is the capital of Portugal, which means it was hosted by Portugal. But that is not all. It was co-hosted by Kenya and Portugal. All right. इसको co-host किया था किसने? Kenya and Portugal ने इसको co-host किया था. Do remember this. Now this conference, why this conference was organized? It was organized to find an international agreement on protecting the world's oceans, seas and other water bodies. Alright. It was co-hosted by Kenya and Portugal and it was a 5-day conference, or you can say 5-day program. But do remember, it was co-hosted by Kenya and Portugal, but it was held at Lisbon. Alright. Union Minister Dr. Jitendra Singh participated from India's side, as I already told you, and the theme was this. ठीक है, इतनी लंबी थीम एग्जाम में पूछी नहीं जाती है, बट वी हैव टू रीड दिस थिंग. दिस इज स्केलिंग अप ओशन एक्शन बेस्ड ऑन साइंस एंड इनोवेशन फॉर द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ गोल 14, स्टॉक टेकिंग पार्टनरशिप एंड सॉल्यूशन. एब्सोल्युटली डोंट हैव टू रिमेंबर गाइस. ठीक है, ऐसी चीज है, अगर आपको कोई याद करने के लिए बोलता है तो मत किया करो यार. ठीक है, बिकॉज इतने लंबे लंबे थीम्स, डेफिनेटली दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू आस्क. और अगर पूछ भी लेते हैं तो कोई बात नहीं, छोड़ देना. वी डोंट हैव टू स्कोर 100 आउट ऑफ 100 इन एग्जामिनेशन. वी हैव to clear the cut off and we have to get into the job. That must be the objective. All right. Gadho wali mehnat, main hamesha kehta hu, gadho wali mehnat mat kiya karo. Okay? Moving ahead. So Dr. Jitendra Singh, who participated from India's side, of course there was a statement from his side. So these are some of the key points from his statements. Number one, India is committed to protect at least 30% of its lands, waters and oceans and thus adhere to its commitment of 30 by 30 by the year 2030. This 30 is 30% and this 30 is 2030. Do you remember this? And India joined the High Ambition Coalition for Nature and People. ठीक है, High Ambition Coalition for Nature and People, which was initiated at One Planet Summit, in Paris in January 2021. And what is this coalition? What is the objective of this coalition? This is for promoting an international agreement to protect at least 30% of world's land by the year 2030. Okay? India will provide science and innovation based solution for implementation of SDG goal 14 through partnership and environmentally friendly solutions. Okay, this is very general statement. Such statements can be used in your essay or in your descriptive answers. Okay, because of course these such points are not important for objective, right? India is committed to the coastal clean seas campaign, which we will discuss in later. Okay, jab ye aur detail mein hamare samne aayega to iske bare mein hum baat karenge. And India has proposed to establish, this is very, very important. India has proposed to establish one thing, which is Sustainable Coastal and Ocean Research Institute. Now, what will this institute do? Ye institute karega kya? It will meet the needs and aspirations of the Pacific Island countries. So, India has, India ne propose kiya hai, India has proposed to establish this institute so that the needs and aspirations of the Pacific Island nations will be fulfilled. All right, so this was all. Now let's come back to the question. The conference was co-hosted by India and Kenya, not India and Kenya, Kenya and Portugal. So this is incorrect. All right, India has proposed to establish Sustainable Coastal and Ocean Research Institute to meet the needs and aspirations of the Pacific Island countries. This is absolutely correct. India ne propose kiya hai, aur bahut cheeze propose hoti hain yaar, but I don't think ki kuch ground pe aa pata hai. India will provide science and innovation based solutions for the implementation of SDG goal 14. Now, so many times we have read SDG goal 14. Can you tell me what is this goal? Write down in the comments. SDG goal 14 ke baare mein batao, kya hai wo goal? So this is also correct. 2 and 3 will be the correct answer because we have to identify the correct statement. Option B will be the correct answer. Okay. Moving ahead to question number 6. Consider the following statements with respect to National Highway Excellence Awards and you have to identify the correct statement. Again, a very important question. Okay? But bahut aasan hai ye. There is no difficulty. Okay? You will not face any difficulty in remembering this. So remember this National Highway Excellence Awards. Which ministry can give it? Of course, it is Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, which is headed by Mr. Nitin Gadkari. His Lok Sabha constituency is Nagpur, which is of course the city of oranges, right? So this Ministry of Road Transport and Highway has conferred the National Highway Excellence Awards 2021. This was the 2021 edition, right? The very first edition of these awards were given in the year 2018, right? And why these awards are given? So these are given to incentivize the stakeholders in the highway constructions and to create a competitive spirit among all the stakeholders which are there in the highway building process. Alright. The awards were initiated in the year 2018. However, the theme for the year 2021 was innovation and excellence in road construction. Alright, this was the theme. Do remember it. And these awards were given in the year 2021. Matlab in this edition, the awards were given in 9 categories. Okay, these are the 9 categories. Now you don't have to remember these 9 categories and the awardees. Of course, there will be awardees na in these categories. You don't have to remember. There is no need of that. Alright. Just remember that there are 9 categories in which the awards were given. Okay. So now let's come back to the question. The awards were first started in 2014. No. Not 2014. Sab kuch 2014 se shuru nahi hua hai. Uske baad bhi hua hai. Usse pehle bhi hua tha. It was started in the year 2018. In 2021 edition, the awards were given in 9 categories. This is absolutely correct. There is no problem in this. And the theme of the awards in 2021 was innovation and excellence in road construction. This is correct. So we have to identify the correct statement, guys, which means option B, only 2 and 3 will be the correct answer to this question. I hope this question is also clear. And without any delay, let's move ahead to question number 7. Very, very important question again. Consider the following statements with respect to launches. All right, with respect to the launches during the Udyami Bharat program, and you have to identify the correct statement. whatever be the launches during the Udyami Bharat program, you have to identify the incorrect statement regarding that, regarding those launches. Alright, so let's talk about this. Now, remember why this Udyami Bharat program? What is this Udyami Bharat program first of all? Remember, this Udyami Bharat program is reflective of the continuous commitment of the government of India towards development of the MSME sector. Alright, and Prime Minister Modi himself participated in this Udyami Bharat program, and he launched various initiatives for development of MSME sector. Alright, now let's talk about those launches. Ki kya kya cheeze launch hui hai. First of all, this scheme, I hope you remember this scheme. It is RAM scheme. It was announced in the Union Budget. It was announced in Union Budget 2022-2023. Of course, you remember this. Now, this has been officially launched now. Alright, now this scheme aims to scale up the implementation capacity and efficiency of the MSME sector of the country, number one. And it will complement the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, of course, by fostering innovation, encouraging ideation, wagaira wagaira. Right? And the total outlay, of course, is rupees 6,000 crores. Alright? Second initiative which has been launched is the new scheme which is capacity building for first time MSME exporters. Capacity building of first time MSME exporter scheme. This is a new scheme. We will discuss it in detail once the details are out. Alright, abhi ke liye unhone itna hi bataya, isse zyada nahi bataya hai. So this scheme aims to encourage MSMEs to offer products and services of international standards for the global market. And this will help the MSME of India to reach the global market as well. Alright. Third initiative is new features. There are some new features of Pradhan Mantri, or you can say Prime Minister's Employment Generation Program now. This scheme we have discussed in detail so many times. If you want to watch, if you want to have the details of this scheme, you can search for Jindal Government Schemes. You will have a playlist of government schemes. There I have discussed the scheme in detail. Okay. Or so there are some new features of PM Employment Generation Program. The very important is the very first. The maximum project cost has been increased from 25 lakh to 50 lakh for the manufacturing sector, and for service sector it has been increased from rupees 10 lakh to rupees 20 lakhs. Alright. Then there is an inclusion of applicants from aspirational districts and transgender in the special category applicants. Alright. And finally, there will be handholding support to those applicants or entrepreneurs through engagement of banking, technical and marketing experts. Alright. This is the third initiative. Fourth initiative was, this was an actually not initiative, the results of MSME Idea Hackathon was announced. Okay, now, why this MSME Idea Hackathon organized? So, it is aimed at promoting and supporting the untapped creativity of individuals, the professionals, the youth, etc., etc. And these selected incubating ideas will be provided funding support of up to rupees 15 lakh. This amount is not fixed. It is the maximum amount that will be given to per approved idea. Alright, and finally, National MSME Awards 2022 were given away by the Prime Minister Modi himself. Now, there is a list of awardees. That is not important. Just remember, this award is a recognition of contribution of MSMEs, states, UTs, aspirational districts and banks for their outstanding performance in the growth and development of India's MSME sector. ठीक है, बेसिकली सब सारे स्टेक होल्डर्स को दिया जाता है जो जो एमएसएमई सेक्टर के डेवलपमेंट के लिए काम कर रहे हैं. दीज अवार्ड्स आर गिवन टू ऑल द स्टेक होल्डर्स विच आर वर्किंग टूवर्ड्स विच आर वर्किंग फॉर डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एमएसएमई सेक्टर. ओके, दैट्स इट. दीज वर द अनाउंसेस, दीज वर द लॉन्चेस. नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. मैक्सिमम प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट अंडर पीएमईजीपी हैज बीन इंक्रीज्ड फ्रॉम 25 लाख टू 50 लाख फॉर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग सेक्टर, करेक्ट. एंड फॉर सर्विस सेक्टर इट हैज बीन इंक्रीज्ड from rupees 10 lakhs to rupees 20 lakhs. And today's session, guys, will be quite long. Okay, as I already told you, and not today, jo kal parso aage ke bhi sessions honge, those sessions will be quite long. Okay, so please thoda sa cooperate kare. Okay, please cooperate. Capacity building of first time MSME exporter scheme has been launched. Bilkul sahi baat hai. And results of MSME idea hackathon were announced. This is also correct. And we have to identify the incorrect statement. Please focus here. Now, none is incorrect will be the correct answer, option D. Moving ahead to question number 8. Consider the following statements with respect to India Chem 2022 and you have to identify the correct statement now. Now, what is this India Camp 2022? It is nothing but an exhibition. It is an exhibition. Now, why it is in news? Was this exhibition held? No. It will held in the month of October. ठीक है ये कब होगा? In the month of October होगा. But now, why it is in news? Because Minister of Chemical and Fertilizer, Mr. Mansukh Mandavia, has chaired the planning meeting of this India Camp 2022. इसकी एक planning के लिए meeting हुई थी and that meeting was chaired by Minister of Chemical and Fertilizers, Mr. Mansukh Mandavia, and that's why this India Camp 2022 is in news. ठीक है the actual event will take place in the month of October this year only. ठीक है now remember it is one of the largest composite events of the chemical and petrochemical sector in the entire Asia Pacific region. All right, and it aims to showcase the potential of the Indian chemical industry, Indian chemical market, Indian chemical stakeholders. Okay, and as I told you, the 12th edition, it will be the 12th edition, and it will be organized by Department of Chemicals and Petrochemicals in association with FICCI. Okay, do remember this. From October 6 to 8, 2022, and finally, there will be a theme of 12th edition, which is Vision 2030, Chemicals and Petrochemicals Build India. And for this, a brochure has also been launched by the minister. Okay, so that's it. Itna hi padhna hai. And now let's come back to the question. All right, you have to identify the correct statement. India Chem 2022 will be the 11th edition. No, pehla statement hi incorrect. It will be the 12th edition, guys. All right, it will be organized by Department of Chemicals and Petrochemicals in association with SOCHAM. Is that so? It will be organized by Department of Chemicals and Petrochemicals, but not in association with SOCHAM, but in association with FICCI. All right, the theme of this edition will be Vision 2030, Chemicals and Petrochemicals Build India. This is correct. There is no problem with this, which means option C, only 3 will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to the next question, question number 9. Ministry of Communication has launched an e-learning portal of Department of Post, and this ministry is headed by Mr. Ashwini Vaishnav, who is also the Minister of Railways, right? And he is a Rajya Sabha MP. Now, therefore, there is no need to remember his constituency. All right, this will enable the trainees to access the uniform standardized training content online. You have to name the portal. Very, very important question. Okay, this is an e-learning portal which has been launched by the Department of Post, of course, for capacity building and efficiency enhancing of the employees of the Department of Post. All right, so let's talk about this. Remember, the name of the portal is Dak Karma Yogi. All right, Dak Karma Yogi, and it has been built in-house. Department of Post ne isko khud hi banaya hai under a mission which is known as Mission Karma Yogi. I hope you guys remember this Mission Karma Yogi, which was launched by the government of India to build the capacity of class A officers. All right, or you can say class B officers also, kyunki ab class B officers ke liye bhi isko kai jagahon pe launch kar diya gaya hai. Right, now this portal will bring efficiency among the employees of Department of Post. Of course, this has been developed in house under Mission Karma Yogi. It will enable the trainees to access the uniform standardized training content online, and they can have this training anytime, anywhere, and with the help of this, they can upgrade their attitude, skill, and knowledge. Okay, so therefore, guys, the correct answer will be what? Dak Karma Yogi. Option C will be the correct answer to this question. Moving ahead to question number 10. Oh yes, this is left. Remember, during this event, when this Dak Karma Yogi was launched, Meghdoot awards were also given. Okay, and these Meghdoot awards were given in 8 different categories, and of course, you don't have to remember the name of all the 8 awardees. That is absolutely not important. Just remember these Meghdoot awards were introduced in the year 1984, and these awards are given to the employees of Department of Post which have worked excellently in their field, right? So this is the highest award of Department of Post at national level for overall performance and excellence, and awardees are conferred with a medal, a certificate, and a cash prize of rupees 21,000. Okay, moving ahead to question number 10. Minister of Information and Broadcasting, who is the minister? Mr. Anurag Singh Thakur, and his Lok Sabha constituency is Hamirpur. Where is Hamirpur? Himachal Pradesh. Has attended the National Conference on Changing Landscape of Media and Entertainment, He has set a target under which media and entertainment industry will generate how much amount annually by the year 2025. Now remember, in such news, only this type of question can be asked regarding any announcement which was made by minister, regarding any initiative launched by any important person. So during this conference, while giving his speech, Minister of Information and Broadcasting Anurag Singh Thakur talked about this industry. एंड उनके कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स निकल के आए हैं जो कि हैं, ये कुछ तीन चार पांच पॉइंट्स हैं, ज्यादा नहीं है. सो नंबर वन, सबसे पहले तो ये है दैट मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन एंड ब्रॉडकास्टिंग अनुराग ठाकुर हैज अटेंडेड दिस कॉन्फ्रेंस, ठीक है. एंड इट वाज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय सिम्बायोसिस स्किल एंड प्रोफेशनल यूनिवर्सिटी विच इज इन पुणे ऑफकोर्स. एंड मिनिस्टर हैज सेट अ टारगेट अंडर विच मीडिया एंड एंटरटेनमेंट इंडस्ट्री will generate rupees 4 lakh crore annually by the year 2025, okay. And this sector will reach $100 billion. Aur abhi ke hisab se baat karein to 7.5 lakh crore by the year 2030, okay. That's it. Yahi 3-4 points hai. So this industry, media and entertainment industry, will generate rupees 4 lakh crore annually by the year 2025. And therefore, it is the correct answer, option D. All right. Moving ahead to the next question, question number 11. All right. Name the event organized by Moil Limited. Now, this company, Moil Limited, remember this, it is a Mini Ratna. It is a Mini Ratna under the Ministry of Steel. All right. So, name the event organized by Moil Limited to thank Government of India for Moil's wage revision, which was approved on 1st November 2021, benefiting more than 5,000 workers. Now, this was in news, and remember this event, the chief guest was Nitin Gadkari, who is the, of course, Minister of Road Transport and Highway. And the name of the event, guys, is Sneh Milan. Option A is the correct answer. And there is no need to go into the details of this news. This much is important. This much is enough. This much is sufficient. All right. Sneh Milan is the correct answer, option A. And the last question for today. How much amount has been allocated to Tamil Nadu for medical infrastructure development under PM Ayushman Bharat Health Infrastructure Mission? Very, very important question. Kitna paisa Tamil Nadu ko diya hai for medical infrastructure development under Pradhan Mantri Ayushman Bharat Health Infrastructure Mission? Can you identify this amount? Yes, it is 404 crores. Option C is the correct answer, guys, to this question. Okay. And that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions and their explanations and their answers are clear. And let me tell you, there will be a session tomorrow also, and there will be a session on Sunday also. This way, we will cover the entire backlog, jo bhi chhut gaya tha. And if you want to enroll in the live course, we have started the live class course for the upcoming RBI Grade B 2023 and the upcoming NABARD Grade A 2022 exam. The classes for ESI, the classes for RBI 2023 will start from 15th of July. However, the classes for NABARD has already been started by Surat sir. Alright, so if you want to enroll in this course, you can visit www.anujindal.in. Alright, and I will see you in the next session tomorrow. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.